ओम नमो ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो ओम शिष्यभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरितः प्रज्ञानगणः प्रत्यगर्तो ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि नारायणं पद्मभूम वसिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्रपराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौड़पदं महांतं गोविंद योगींद्र मथासि शिष्यं श्रीशंकराचार्य मथासि पद्मपादं च हस्तामलकं च शिष्यं तन्तोत्तमस्मि श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तमा विद्विषावहै ओम शांति 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 यद् ब्रह्म गोचर विचित्रतम प्रभाव संसार धीजनित दुखम अभूत जनस्य यद् ब्रह्म धीजनित सौख्यम अभूत तस्य तम रुक्मिणी सहित कृष्णं नमामि यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकशाङ्कमनन्त सुखाकृतिम् So, we were looking at two hetus given as to why Shastriya Karma is also Adhyasa, or rather two hetus while establishing that Shastriya Karma is also adhyasa as compared to laukika. There were two hetus given as to atmajnana being needed. Purvapakshi has said that atmajnana is there for a karmakandi. Therefore, it cannot be considered as an adhyasa. His vyavahara cannot be considered as an adhyasa. Two hetus were given to say that शास्त्रीय तु व्यवहारे यद्यपि बुद्धिपूर्वकारी नाद अविदित्वा आत्मनः परलोक संबंधम अधिक्रियते तथापि न वेदांत वेद्यम अशनायाद्यतीतम अपेत ब्रह्मक्षत्रादि भेदम असंसारी आत्मतत्त्वम अधिकारे अपेक्षते. यस, देयर इज एन अपेक्षा ऑफ आत्मतत्व ज्ञान, बट व्हाट काइंड ऑफ आत्मतत्व ज्ञान? नॉट रियल तत्व ज्ञान, आत्म ज्ञान मीनिंग परलोक संबंध आत्म ज्ञान is needed, meaning the sharira will be dissociated from by that atma which is my nature, who will have paraloka gati. That much knowledge is sufficient. Further than atma tattva, meaning brahmatma tattva, aikya tattva is not necessary to be known. It may or may not be known. In fact, if it is known, then it cannot be called as karma anymore. It will become karmabhasa. So what minimal knowledge is needed as atma being separate from the body, that is necessary for a karmi also, which is agreeable. But then atma tattva is not needed for adhikara in karma, that asamsari atma, free from brahmanatva, kshatriyatva, free from hunger and thirst, free from bhoga, basically bhokta atma. The knowledge of Atma being Bhokta is actually needed because one is looking forward to Swarga Bhoga, whereas Abhokta Atma is what is revealed by the Shruti. That Tatparya Nishchaya is not needed. And two hetus were given. Anupayogat, Adhikara Virodhacha. So Anupayoga, there is no Upayoga. If you know yourself as Brahmatma, what is it serving? I mean, what purpose is it serving for a Karmi who wants Swarga Ityadi? And adhikara itself is not there. If you know yourself as Brahmatma, you have no adhikara in karma that leads to swarga adi, because you have adhikara in jnana. You are no longer a bhokta. You consider yourself as bhokta, then alone you want bhoga in swarga ityadi. So adhikara virodhacha. Further in the tika, vyakhyana. शास्त्रीय कर्मण अध्यास अध्यास जन्यत्व निगमयति. फाइनली ही कंक्लूड्स, वी सॉ दिस प्राक्च, वी आल्सो सॉ दिस, सो आई सेड दैट आई कंक्लूड बाय सेइंग प्राक्च. सो वी सॉ दैट आल्सो एज टू प्राक्च तथाभूत आत्मविज्ञानात् प्रवर्तमानं शास्त्रं अविद्यावत् विषयत्वं न अतिवर्तते. सो व्हाट हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड एज प्रमाणानि प्रत्यक्षादीनि प्रमाणानि शास्त्राणि च अविद्यावत् विषयाणि, दैट हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड. नाउ तथा ही इज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द व्याख्यानकार बाय सेइंग अध्यासे आगमं प्रमाणयति. फॉर अध्यास नॉट ओनली प्रत्यक्ष अनुमान एंड अन्यथानुपपत्ति मीनिंग अर्थापत्ति प्रमाण एग्जिस्ट बट ऑल्सो शास्त्र प्रमाण शब्द प्रमाण आगम प्रमाण. सो शास्त्र इटसेल्फ सेज व्हेन यू डू अग्निहोत्रादि कर्म और ज्योतिष्टोमादि कर्म फॉर स्वर्ग प्राप्ति, that time it reveals adhyasa along with it. How so? So adhyase agamam pramanati. Agama is shruti. Tathahi iti. So Bhagavan Bhashyakara says tathahi brahmano yajeta ityadini shastrani atmani varnashrama vayovastha adi. So वर्णाश्रम वयो अवस्थादि विशेषाध्यासम आश्रित्य प्रवर्तन्ते. सो शास्त्राणि प्रवर्तन्ते, शास्त्रास आल्सो हैव अ प्रवृत्ति इन प्रोडिंग द अधिकारी टू डू अ पर्टिकुलर कर्म. ओनली इफ द अधिकारी कंसिडर्स वनसेल्फ एज बिलोंगिंग टू अ पर्टिकुलर वर्ण, पर्टिकुलर आश्रम, पर्टिकुलर वयस, पर्टिकुलर अवस्था इत्यादि. सो ब्राह्मणो यजेत व्हेन इट हैज बीन सेड, देन ओनली इफ यू कंसीडर युअरसेल्फ एज अ ब्राह्मण यू डू याग. नाउ हु कंसीडर्स वनसेल्फ एज अ ब्राह्मण? ऑफ कोर्स वन हु इज बॉर्न इन अ फैमिली ऑफ ब्राह्मणास और वन हु इज अनबॉर्न. Is it an ajata atma who has no varnashrama vayovastha? That kind of a person who is a jnani, will that jnani consider himself as a brahmana and do yagadi? Or one who considers that I was born in this particular family? Obviously the latter, which means that brahmanatvam, which is stula deha dharma, is adhyastha in atma. So by saying brahmano yajeta, it is a vidhi to a brahmana, one who considers oneself as a brahmana, that a kshatriya should do rajasuya yajna, that is a vidhi to a person who considers oneself as a kshatriya. Therefore brahmano yajeta ityadini shastrani atmani varnashrama vayovasthadi vishesha adhyasam ashritya pravartante. There is a particular adhyasa which is shown by saying brahmana. Brahmanatvam is adhyasta in a person who wants to do this yaga, who considers this as a vidhi applicable to me. Therefore, adhyasa is also established by shabda pramana, agama. Vyakhyana. तथा ही इति यथा प्रत्यक्षानुमान अर्थापत्तयः अध्यासे प्रमाणं तथा आगमोपि इत्यर्थः. जस्ट लाइक प्रत्यक्ष, व्हाट इज ए प्रत्यक्ष प्रमाण शोन फॉर अध्यास, अहम मनुष्य इत्यादि. देन अहम मनुष्य, अहम ब्राह्मण इत्यादि. एंड देन व्हाट एल्स? प्रत्यक्ष प्रमाण. देन अनुमान, वी हैव सीन अन्वय व्यतिरेक ऑफ व्यवहार एंड अध्यास. अन्यथा अनुपपत्ति, वी हैव सीन व्यवहार इज नॉट पॉसिबल अनलेस अध्यासा इज देयर. सो अन्यथा अनुपपत्या अर्थापत्या, वी हैव सीन दैट अध्यासा इज डेफिनेटली देयर. अदर देन दिस ऑल्सो देयर इज शब्द प्रमाण. सो यथा प्रत्यक्ष अनुमान अर्थापत्तय अध्यासे प्रमाणम तथा आगमोपि इत्यर्थः. सिमिलरली देयर इज शब्द प्रमाण, श्रुति प्रमाण ऑल्सो फॉर अध्यासा. ब्राह्मणो यजेत नह वै स्नात्वा भिक्षेत अष्टवर्षं ब्राह्मणं उपनयीत कृष्णकेशो अग्नीन अददीत आददीत कृष्णकेशो अग्नीन आददीत इति आगमः ब्राह्मणादि पदैः अधिकारणं वर्णादि अभिमाननम् अनुवदन अध्यासं गमयति इति भावः. When the Shruti says Brahmana Yajit, it is not saying you are a Brahmana. It is saying if you are a Brahmana, then you do this Yaga. If you consider yourself as a Brahmana. So Brahmanatvam, the mention of Brahmanatvam in the Shruti, that is only an Anuvada. Because you already consider yourself as a Brahmana Kshatriya Ityadi. So if the Shruti mentions that, it is just something which is not a Vidhi. Brahmanatvam in Brahmano Yajet is Brahmana Pada is not a Vidhi. Yajeta is a Vidhi if you did not know that there is something called as Yaga. So those who have studied Pura Mimamsa Artha Sangraha, they know Vidhi is not the entire statement. Vidhi is whatever is aprapta even in that particular sentence, in the Vakya. Whatever is aprapta by Anya Pramana. Anya Pramana includes Veda Pramana also. So if in the same Veda Shaka or any Veda Shaka, if you are looking at a Vakya and a particular word has not occurred earlier, particular Padartha is not known earlier and such a Pada occurs in this sentence, then it is a Vidhi. Now Brahmana, when this word occurs, you don't have to look up other Vedas to know who is a Brahmana. You already know the meaning of Brahmana. Brahmanatvam is prapta. Therefore, Brahmana is not a Vidhi. What is a Vidhi? Yaga. Yajeta by this. Yajithatu plus the pratyaya. Akhyata and vijiling. That is the Vidhi. So that Yajeta word is a Vidhi. To whom is it a Vidhi? It is a Vidhi to someone who already knows that I am Brahmana. So Brahmana Shabda is an Anuvada. That is mentioned here as Brahmanadi padehi adhikarinam varnadi abhimaninam. One who already has varnashrama dharma abhimana. Varnashrama abhimana. Varna vayaha avastha abhimana is already there. So it's an anuvada. Varnadi abhimaninam anuvadan. Making an anuvada. Shatrantapada. Anuvadan adhyasam gamayati. Gamayati causative. Nijanta. It makes the adhyasa known, which you already have. Brahmanatvam is already an adhyasa and Agama Brahmanadi. So Agamaha Gamayati. Kim Gamayati? Adhyasam Gamayati. Agama, so adhyasa being masculine, samanya napunsakam, but otherwise, but you'll say, Kam gamayati, adhyasam gamayati. It reveals the adhyasa which is not known. You don't know that there is an adhyasa when you consider yourself as a brahmana, but it is an adhyasa. Further, there are other examples given. Nahavai snatva bhikshetha. So there are many such, in each and every sentence, whatever is the adhikarityam revealed there. There itself, adhyasa is revealed. Then, ashtavarsham brahmanam upanayita. There also adhyasa is revealed. Because, vayas is known, ashtavarsham. When a brahmana is 8 years old, then he is Upanayana should be done. When a brahmachari is 8, in fact not a brahmachari also, he cannot be called as a brahmachari because brahmachari is only when he takes the yajnopavita. This yajnopavita samskara should be done. Upanayita, upanayana should be done of a brahmana who is 8 years. For kshatriya, other rules. For vaishya, you know, other ages. There are age limits. So now, ashtavarsham brahmana upanayita, what does it tell you? Brahmana pada is also there, ashtavarsha is also there. So vayovastha, varnashrama vayovastha, all these are adhyasa. Krishna kesho agneen adadita. So who should get married? or rather when the father of the bride is looking for a groom, he should not marry her off to someone who does not have Krishna Kesha. In fact, because this Agni in Adhita is an Adhikara in Agnikarya. Agnihotra. Agnikarya is something that Brahmachari does. Agnihotra, for the Adhikara in Agnihotra, one should be married. One should have Patni. So that time, who has this Adhikara? In fact, this shows that Krishna Kesha, one who has Krishna Kesha, one who has, his hair is still black, it is not graying out. Nowadays with this, you know, genetically or with all that is happening with all the, you know, adulterated products that we are using, even the kids have grey hair. So if you go strictly by the Vedas, they don't have Adhikara in Agnihotra. Why? Because Krishna Keshaha Agnin Adadita. Anyway, that's an aside. But what does it tell you? Avastha. Krishna Kesha Avastha. Oh, my hair is still dark. So that person who has that hair, which is meaning he should be young enough, then only he has Adhikara in to begin the Agnihotradhikarya, meaning get married and do Agnihotradhikarya. And it also shows, first of all, Krishna shows that his hair is not graying. Other thing shows, Kesha shows that he should have hair. These days people start losing hair at earlier age, and whatever is left, that is not black. Anyway, that's a lighter note. So Krishna Kesha Agni Nadadita Itti Agamaha Brahmana Adipadehi Adhikaranam. So Adipadehi, it need not be only Brahmana. So Krishna Kesha is also Pada, which is already known. Whether you have black hair or you have grey hair, you know that. Whether you have hair or not, the hairline is thinning, you know that. So Itti Agam Brahmana Adipadehi Adhikaranam Varnadi Abhimaninam. One who has Abhimana, Tadatmya Sambandha is already there. Therefore, it is an anuvada, adu anuvadan agamaha adhyasam gamayati iti bhava evam adhyase pramana siddhyapi kasya kutra adhyasaha iti jidnyasayam tam udahartum lakshanam smarayati. So, lakshana has already been talked about in different ways. Different ways in sense as to what the siddhanta considers and what the other darshanikas consider, but sarvata api tu, as to what is common, anyatra. Anyatra anya dharma. So that has been said. Now he reminds you of that when the question is, okay, adhyasa is siddha by pratyaksha anumana arthapatti and agama pramana also. Evam adhyase pramana siddhyapi. Pramanaihi siddhyapi. Tritiya tatpurusha. Although it is established by multiple pramanas. Bahuvachana. Four pramanas have been shown. Tathapi kasya kutra adhyasa. In the opening itself, it has been said, Yushmad Asmad Pratyay Gocharevo. But then, now to sum up, what exactly in detail, what exactly is the Adhyasa? Of what unto what? Only one way or both ways? Only Dharmi or Dharma Adhyasa also? What kind of Dharmas? Samplings have to be given. So, with that intention, Kasya Kutra Adhyasa Iti Jidnyasa, when there is Nyatum Ichha, there is Ichha to know as to what exactly is the Adhyasa, of what onto what. Tam Udahartum Lakshanam Smarayati, he gives examples. So, to give examples, first of all, Bhagavan Bhashyakara reminds what is the definition of Adhyasa. So, you know it is Anyatra, Anyadharma Ityadi. So, Adhyaso Namiti, he gives the Lakshana once again as to in a simpler language. Summing up, all the darshanikas agree to this kind of adhyasa. Adhyaso nama atasmins tadbuddhir ityavochama. What do we say? He says, we say adhyasa is what? Atasmin tadbuddhi. Atasmin is a nun. Tadbuddhi. Tat is a sarvanama, pronoun. Atasmin in that tat is also pronoun. So, literally what does it mean? In non that, having the notion of that. meaning wherever thatness doesn't belong, you are seeing thatness in that adhikarana. So atasmin, which is in non that, in non that, meaning in a non sarpa, seeing that means seeing sarpa, that is atyasa. Seeing sarpa in non sarpa is adhyasa. Seeing sarpa in a non sarpa rajju is adhyasa. Seeing rajata in a non rajata shukti is adhyasa. It's a very simple definition. In non that means anyatra, it is not definitely not that. Anyatra, paratra. So here atasmin tad buddhi, tasya buddhi, meaning the buddhi of that, the notion, idea of that, in which is not that. Iti avocham, a very simple definition summing up in words which appear to be complicated. Atasmin tad buddhi. But it cannot be simpler in that, simpler than this, because paratra, paravabhasa, have to explain what is avabhasa. Ava has to be understood. Abhasa, paratra. That is also simple. But then, this is in a different language. Using only single pronoun, he has explained. Only one word, tat. One pratipadika tat has been declined differently with a buddhi showing that the notion. It is because all this happens in the buddhi. It also shows that the misunderstanding will go only with the buddhi. The notion which is erroneous can be set right only in that adhikarana where that erroneous notion exists. So in the buddhi where there is atasmin buddhi, atasmin tad buddhi, sorry, that meaning in place of atat there is tad buddhi. Where asarpa is there is sarpa buddhi. If one can know asarpatvam there instead of sarpatvam, meaning rajyatvam is known there, then the sarpa buddhi will go away. So it also shows that buddhi, the shabda buddhi shows that buddhi itself is tin pratyanta. Akartari chakareke sanyayam. It can be used in any sense other than karta. Generally we seek tin in bhave artha. Generally, it can also be karmani. It can also be adhikarane. It can also be karane, tritiya, tritiya vitpatya. So these are possibilities. So, sanyayam, asanyayam. Generally sanyayam, but kvachit asanyayam api. Although there is no rudhi artha, sometimes it may be used by sadhus. So sadhu prayoga is there, we can go along with it, that such a vitpatti is possible. So this buddhi does not only mean by bhave vitpatti only the notion, it can also mean the adhikarana in which it takes place. So it indicates that in that adhikarana it can be set right. I am not saying that vivaksha is there, but it can also be there. We can see that, read more into it. It shows jnanena moksha, jnana devatu kaivalyam. So adhyaso nama atasmin tadbuddhir ityavochama, this is only reminded by Bhagavan Bhashyakara now to explain further as to kutra kasya adhyasaha. In the vyakhyana further, udaharati, he gives an example, tadyatheti. So an example is given further as to, so there is only a word or two there, so we have to go back to mula there. So udaharana, kasya kutra adhyasaha, so he gives an example, more than one. At various levels there is adhyasaha. It starts off, it can be separate in the buddhi alone, but the adhyasa is at various levels. It is at the deha level, it is at the anya deha level also. We have seen earlier gauna atma. From the perspective of the parent, especially the mother towards the child. So from the perspective of the parent towards the child, what kind of sambandha is there? The dharma adhyasa is there. Putre pushto aham pushtaha. Putre pushte sati aham pushtaha. Sati saptami. if the child is nourished, then I feel nourished. If the child is healthy, I feel healthy. Says the things, this is thinking of the parent. When the child is unhealthy, mother can't sleep. Why? She does not feel the pain, but then there is pain. She can't feel the bodily pain of the child, but she feels the pain emotionally. Gauna Atma, there is a sambandha of the with the child in such a way that the attributes of the child, the dharma, gunas of the child are superimposed on oneself. So the pain is felt by the mother. This is adhyasa, dharma adhyasa. At that level there is an adhyasa. There is an adhyasa. Why is it there? Because the child has come from the child's body. Is part of the parent's body. It has grown out of the parent's body. It has grown in the mother's womb. Therefore, it can be seen. It is pratyaksha to the mother that the child's body is an extension of my body. Especially the mother can feel it. So there is, it shows that unless there is the sharira dharma adhyasa, sharira adhyasa of one's own unto atma, the child sharira dharma cannot be adhyasta in oneself. So before the child's dharma, the putra dharma are superimposed on oneself, one's own sharira dharma has to be superimposed on oneself. So preceding that there is dehadhyasa, swadehadhyasa. Before the putra, putra or putri, putra is upalakshana or putri also. Putra putri, dehadhyasa, deha dharmadhyasa, the swadehadhyasa has to be there. And for that to happen, this buddhi says that buddhi to take place, atasmin tad buddhi, unto non-deha, non-putra deha, there is adhyasa. Meaning, non-atma, putra deha, there is atmatva adhyasa and vice versa. In a non-deha atma also, there is a deha adhyasa, both ways. In a non-atma deha, there is atma adhyasa because there is chaitanya felt in the deha. And in the non-deha atma, ajada, in the non-ajada rather, in the non-ajada chaitanya atma, there is dehadhyasa. So both works both ways, atasmin tad buddhi. Very nicely said, so paratra kutra, atasmin, in non-that. What is non-that? Both ways you can see. What we saw earlier as samsarga adhyasa and the tatmya. Meaning swarupa, swarupa adhyasa. Samsarga adhyasa and swarupa adhyasa. Both ways, both aren't there. Swarupa exists. The adhisthana adhikarana swarupa exists. In the Rajju Sarpa example also, Rajju swarupa exists. Rajju exists by swarupa, whereas sarpa does not exist by swarupa. So there is only samsarga adhyasa of Rajju unto the sarpa, but other way around, there are both samsarga and swarupa adhyasa because the sarpa does not exist from in swarupa itself. It is not there at all. So swarupa is also adhyasta in Rajju and samsarga adhyasa is also there. Tadatmya. Here also it will be extended here. Now this atasmin tadbuddhir ityavachama, what are the examples? Tadyatha. And further to complete the earlier thinking, the deha adhyasa, the putra deha, putra deha dharma adhyasa cannot be there unto oneself unless there is swadeha adhyasa, and that swadeha adhyasa cannot be there unto atma unless there is sukshma sharira adhyasa. Stula sharira adhyasa cannot be there unless sukshma sharira adhyasa is there. Therefore, that buddhi, tad buddhi also shows that there is antakarana adhyasta in oneself. Antakarana adhyasa has to be there before dehadhyasa, swadehadhyasa happens and extend into putradi. putra is also an upalakshana for others, you know, somebody who is a very close friend or a sibling, especially twins. There is that kind of adhyasa there also. One twin suffers, the other also suffers. There is some connection there. So, tadyatha putra bharyadishu vikaleshu sakaleshu va ahameo vikalaha sakalo va iti bahya dharman atmanyadhyasyati tatha deha dharman. So, putra bharyadishu. The putra example I have shown with that bharya. The patni also. They say better half or whatever, because it's finally, who is a patni? Bharya, who is a bharya? Patni as per the sutra, Vyakrana sutra, it is patyuhu yajna sambandhi. So, sambandhini, you have to, so the sutra is saying patyuhu yajna sambandhe ni nakara. So, nakara is there. So, ikara, pati ikara is replaced by nakara. And then you have gneep for strilinga. You get pat, pat, ikara goes away, nakara comes in, you get patna, which cannot be pronounced. And then there is an ikara for strilinga, you get patni. So patni is someone who has yajna sambandha, who comes to the, meaning who is associated, who comes into association with this person only as a yajna sambandha. Nothing else can be called as a marriage, and she has adhikara in yajna only when the husband is there. So along with the husband, even the husband has the adhikara only when the wife is there. So that wife or any other word does not do justice. So one who is doing yaga, agnihotra adi yaga, any of these yagas, and with the yajna sambandha alone, she is patni. Otherwise there is no patnitvam there. So very interesting that all the other words or all other ways of marriage also are invalidated. They are not really marriages per se. All these, you know, signing an affidavit or whatever, you know, the court marriages or through other religions. As per the Vyakrana Sutra, Patni is someone who is associated by Yajna Sambandha. So with this Sambandha, now further what kind of a Sambandha? They are inseparable. They become inseparable. They grow old together. As per the Veda Shastra perspective, there is no concept of divorce, etc. So we are looking at a culturally Vedic society where putra bharya adishu, and then what happens? I'm not denying the fact that this adhyasa is not there in other religions or other cases, but I just, you know, with the occasion I'm mentioning this patni as who is a patni. So bharya is that patni who is yajna sambandhini. Further, as they are, whether or they are doing yaga or not, when they grow together as a family, there is a different kind of an association than one has with the child, but still that association is there. There is still pain when the spouse suffers. Therefore, putra bharyadishu and adipadena, anyone who is close, that, you know, you are inseparable since childhood, that kind of a friend, if that friend is suffering, it can be intuitive also. You need not have to be there to see the suffering. Emotional attachment is such, the sukshma sharira is connected in such a manner that across the globe also one can feel the pain. You don't know why. Some intuitive things can happen and then you realize that, oh, I had a bad dream or whatever. And then you end up calling your friend who is, you know, halfway across the globe, who is hurt, and you feel the hurt. If nothing, you feel subtly in the dream. All these are possibilities, we know of all this. But what is it really? Because that attachment is there. Even if you don't know, oh, you have been separated for 5-10 years, but suddenly there is some recollection of the childhood friend. You don't know why, but then you have a desire, strong desire to talk to that person. There is nostalgia. Because the emotional connection is there. How does this happen? We can't see what it is. But it is all adhyasa, because the deha itself is adhyasta. The antakkarana, where you have emotions, that is also adhyasta. So putra bharyadishu vikaleshu sakaleshu, whether they, you know, if they are suffering vikala, or they are getting nourished, they are happier, whatever. Sakala, kala is a part. Whether a part diminishes and thereby there is disease, vikala, or sakala meaning kalaihi sahavartati iti sakala. Vikala is panchami tatpura. So, vigata kalaha yasmat saha vikala teshu vikaleshu. So, if the parts are having wear and tear, parts of the body, thereby the putra bharya ityadi are suffering. Or sakala meaning, oh, parts are completely well, they are all together the way they should be. Then they are happy, they are at ease. So whether they are diseased or whether they are at ease, va ahamyo vikalaha sakalo va, respectively, I feel that I myself am suffering or I am feeling nourished and satisfied. Iti bahya dharma. These are all about bahya dharma. Putra bharya, they are outside your body. Anakav paryantebhyaha. There is adhyasa. Dehadhyasa is up to the tip of the nails. Krishna Kesha shows that although my hair is insentient, still it is me. It is still me. My hair is black. So that mamatva abhimana is there by ahankara unto that, unto the sharira. Thereby, bahya dharman, compared to my body, the putra bharya are outward. There is no such, there is no such confusion. If a person has some buddhi, then anyone knows that my putra sharira is different, my bharya sharira is different, my spouse is different from, different body from me. My children have different body from my friends, even the closest friend. He is still separate from me, he has a different body. So, bahya dharman, their sakalattvam, vikalattvam is the sharira dharma, their sharira dharma, not even my sharira dharma, but still atmani adhyasyati, because aham vikala sakala, meaning that vikalattvam in the other sharira is superimposed on myself. My real swarupa, I am confusing so further out that it is outside my sharira also. Tatha deha dharman. Similarly, easier to understand. Bhagavan Bhashyakara starts from the outermost so that it is easier to see the, as you go within, it is all. By Kaimitika Nyaya, it is very easy to understand. So, bahya dharma themselves are adhyastha. What to talk about? Swadeha and Swantakkarana dharmas. So, tatha deha dharman, stuloham, krushoham, gauroham, tishtami gachami, langayami chaiti. So, deha dharmas, what are these? Stuloham, I am fat, stout, whatever. Krushoham, I am lean. Gauroham, I am fair, fair looking. Tishtami, I am standing. Gachami, I am going. Langhayami, I am jumping. Ityadi. So, chaiti. Tatha, indriya dharman. Similarly, the indriya dharmas also, the sense organs, whether they are leading to a 20-20 eyesight or blindness. Whether I can hear something which at a very high frequency, 20-20, 22, 20 kilohertz range, 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz range. Generally, although that is the range, not all human beings or most of the human beings don't hear the entire range. But then I can hear something which is at a very high frequencies, almost towards what dogs can hear. So, I have got very sharp ears. This is all superimposition. So, tatha indriya dharma, mukaha, kaanaha, kleebaha, badiraha, andaha, amiti. So, whether I am dumb or, squint-eyed, ityadi, whether napunchakattvam is there, badiraha, andaha, all these are superimposed on oneself. So, not only, so basically, what is the idea? By starting off with the Anya Deha Dharma, by showing Putra Bharyadi Dharma superimposed on oneself, that itself is superimposed by Anubhava, you know. And there you cannot question, there you can say, oh, it is, my friend is mine, my Bharya is mine, my Putra is mine, but you cannot claim the Sharira to be yours. Finally, the child is going to grow up and say, even culturally, he is going to say, this is my life. he or she is going to have her own, his or her own choices. That much you have to accept as a parent some point of time anyway. But anyway, nobody has that bhranti that that entire body belongs to me. Others' bodies, others' bodies. There is no confusion at all. But still, there is confusion in the emotion there. Aham vikala sakala. Therefore, if that is possible, which is adhyasa clearly, that body is not yours, that deha cannot be, deha dharma cannot be yours, but still if you consider that, then what to speak about adhyasa of everything else? It is easier to see. It can be difficult also in another way. Oh, but others dharmas, I can see that that is adhyasa, but how can this be adhyasa? That can be a question, a valid question. But the process is to show that even when it is clear as day and night, that kind of division is clear between your body and the other's body, but still you have superimposition. So it leads to sambhavana, that if that is possible, then why can't it be possible that you are unable to see that they are different? Meaning the sharira and indriyas are different from you, are unable to see, why not inquire into that? There is a sambhavana at least. Because it is possible in the case of others where there is clear difference, but still you have aikya or some kind of an adhyasa, samsarga. Why not in your case that since there is a samsarga, since there is ahamityanena vyavaharaha, yatra yatra vyavahara tatra tatra adhyasa, with that vyapti, why can't you think of it to be a possibility that my deha dharmas, my indriya dharmas, my antakarana dharmas may also have been adhyasta in me? So it gives, it opens up a way for thinking into this adhyasa as a possibility. Vyakhyana. Tata. So, उदाहरति तद्यथा इति तल्लक्षणं यथा स्पष्टं भवति तथा उदाह्रियते इत्यर्थः. सो उदाहरण इज गिवन इन सच अ मैनर दैट अतस्मिन् तद्बुद्धि इति लक्षण, दैट डेफिनेशन विच वाज गिवन एज टू कॉग्निशन ऑफ दैट दैटनेस इन दैट विच डज नॉट हैव दैटनेस, मीनिंग सीइंग दैट इन नॉन दैट, दैट डेफिनेशन द वे इट बिकम्स क्लियर. तथा उदाह्रियते, they are exemplified, sampled in such a manner that the definition becomes clear. Those are the udharanas. Swadehat bhedena pratyakshaha putradayaha bahyaha tadharman sakalyadin deha vishishtatmani adhyasyati. Anyway, I'll read this and we'll go the other way around also and see. So swadehat bhedena pratyakshaha putradayaha bahyaha तद्धर्मान् साकल्यादीन् देहविशिष्टात्मनि अध्यस्यति तद्धर्मज्ञानात् स्वस्मिन् तत्तुल्यधर्मान् अध्यस्यति इत्यर्थः. सो व्हेन वन डज एन अध्यासा ऑफ द पुत्र भार्यादि धर्माज ऑन टू वनसेल्फ, सकलत्वं विकलत्वं, देर स्वदेहात् भेदेन प्रत्यक्षः. The putradaya, putra bharya, they are clearly known by pratyaksha pramana. You directly perceive them to be different from your own deha. So, swadehat bhedena. They are seen as different from your own deha. There is absolutely no confusion to whosoever. Putradaya bahyaha, they are outward to your deha. They are not you. Just like the table, chair is not you. Putra bharya is not you. This is very clear to you. But still, तद्धर्मान इस पुत्र भार्यादि धर्मान साकल्यादीन, विच आर दिस, सकलत्वम विकलत्वम और साकल्यम वैकल्यम, शेंज प्रत्यय इंस्टेड ऑफ त्व शेंज फॉर तस्य भावः. सो सकल दि साकल्य धर्म इज दि तद्देह धर्म, तद्धर्म पुत्र धर्म, भार्य धर्म, साकल्य वैकल्य इज देयर धर्म, ऑल ऑफ दीज देह विशिष्ट आत्मनि अध्यस्यति, वेयर इट इज सुपर इम्पोज्ड. व्हेन द सन इज नरिश्ड हेल्दी, then I feel that I am nourished, meaning my body is nourished. I feel that my body is nourished. When the sun's body is nourished, when the sun's stomach is full, he's sleeping happily. Oh, he has eaten today. He wasn't well till afternoon, didn't eat. At night, the sun ate. The mother feels happy. She feels that her hunger is, you know, I don't need to eat anymore. My son has eaten. So, deha dharma, which is there. Here, of course, prana, hunger. But then, an example to drive home the point that when the sun feels healthy, body is healthy, my body feels healthier. So, deha vishishta atmani, not in unto the atma directly, not into my swarupa directly, but I am already considering myself as the mother. Because for me to be a mother, I should have given birth to a body which is part of my body. Therefore, my body is already adhyasta unto me. So, deha vishishta, I already have visheshana of deha. That I am a mother, that I am a parent, with that idea, already the stritvam of the sharira has been superimposed. Deha dharma is already there, swadeha dharma is already there. So, deha is my visheshana now. Who am I? I am a stri, I am a purusha. This is already adhyasta. So, deha vishishta atmani, that atma which has got extended unto my deha, that is me. Unto that I have adhyasa of the putra dharma, bharya dharma, tad dharma jnanat, swasmin, tad tulya dharman adhyasyati charta. What is the real idea? How can you superimpose the putra dharma onto yourself? Because what have we seen? This is dharma adhyasa. And dharmadhyasa is not possible unless there is dharmiadhyasa. Putra sharira cannot be having any samsarga. Some sambandha is there. Mata putra sambandha is there. But there is no sambandha as to the association in such a manner that there is no physical connection now. The child is not in the mother's womb anymore. It's outside, bahya. So being outside, how can there be dharmadhyasa? Because dharmiadhyasa cannot be possible. So what is the idea? Tat tulya dharman. If the child has sakalyam, is healthy, then that health is not superimposed onto my sharira. That being healthy, sakalyam is not superimposed on myself, but similar sakalyam is superimposed. When the son is satisfied, then I am satisfied. The same satisfaction is not superimposed on me, but adhyasa is of a similar satisfaction. I have similar satisfaction. Therefore, taddharman adhyasyati, meaning taddharma jnanat, knowing that my son is healthy, sakalya or vaikalya is there in the son, then swasmin tattulya, that similar. Sakalya tulya or vaikalya tulya dharma is superimposed on myself because there is no possibility of superimposing that very dharma. Bheda paroksha jnane tad dharma adhyasa yogat. Why so? Why do you say tattulya? Why not say the same attribute is superimposed? No, not the same. Why? Bheda aparoksha jnane. I already have aparoksha pratyaksha jnana, aparoksha, directly perceive that the sharira bheda is there. Putra sharira is different from me. Bharya deha is different from me. Mitra deha is different from me. My deha. So there is a difference between my deha and that deha. Then the other deha dharma cannot be my deha dharma. That is very clear. Therefore, bheda aparoksha jnane sati, which is already there. There is no doubt here. Tad dharma. Tad dharma is bhinna deha dharma. Bhinna deha dharma adhyasa ayoga. It is ayogya. You cannot have other deha's dharma superimposed unto your own deha. That is not possible. Therefore, tattulya. Anyata khyatyangi karacha iti drashtavyam. So, here there is a purvapaksha. Why not you take that this dharma is in the anya sharira, but that sakalya vaikalya which is in putra who has bhinna deha, putra deha. It is in putra deha which is bhinna to you. Swasmad bhinna deha, but still, why not have anyatra adhyasa? Like the tarkika say, anyatha khyati, why not have anyatha अन्य प्रकारेण अन्यत्र अध्यास नो सच अध्यास इज नॉट पॉसिबल बिकॉज इन सच केसेस वी डोंट एक्सेप्ट अन्यथाख्याति अनंगीकाराचेति सम केसेस वी एक्सेप्ट बट नॉट इन ऑल केसेस सम केसेस वेर अनिर्वचनीय ख्याति इज नॉट नीडेड देयर वी एक्सेप्टेड लाइक इन दी रक्तस्फटिका हियर देयर इज नो सच काइंड ऑफ एन ओकेशन सो अन्यथाख्याति अनंगीकारात यू कैनॉट से दैट ओ इट इज एल्सवेयर बट आई सुपर इम्पोज ऑन माई सेल्फ दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल हियर इट इज अनिर्वचनीय ख्याति देयर इज एन उत्पत्ति ऑफ सिमिलर धर्म इन माई देह वेन आई सी दी पुत्र हैविंग साकल्य सो सिमिलर साकल्यम अन्यथा अनुपपत्य हैज ऑल बीन शोन देयर इज प्रत्यक्ष इट इज प्रत्यक्ष दैट द शरीर इज डिफरेंट द शरीर धर्म इज डिफरेंट बट इन माई शरीर देयर इज ऑल्सो प्रत्यक्ष ऑफ वाई फील सैटिस्फैक्शन वेन माई सन इज हेल्दी आई फील हेल्दी देयर फोर अन्यथा अनुपपत्य आई हैव टू एक्सेप्ट दैट इज अध्यास एंड सिंस आई डोंट एक्सेप्ट अन्यथा ख्याति देन अनिर्वचनीय ख्याति इट इज देयर इज एन उत्पत्ति ऑफ सिमिलर तत्तुल्य धर्म इन माई शरीर सो अन्यथा ख्याति अनंगीकाराच्च इति द्रष्टव्यम् देह इंद्रिय धर्मान् मनो विशिष्ट आत्मनि अध्यस्यति इति आह तथा इति सिमिलरली देह धर्मास स्वदेह धर्मास एंड इंद्रिय धर्मास आल्सो आर सुपरइम्पोज्ड ऑन वन सेल्फ देयरफॉर द वे दी अन्य शरीर धर्मास आर अध्यस्त इन देह विशिष्ट आत्मा सिमिलरली देह धर्म स्वदेह धर्मास आर अध्यस्त इन दी मनो विशिष्ट आत्मा मन इंद्रिय मन विशिष्ट आत्मा सो देहे एंड इंद्रिय धर्मास आर सुपरइम्पोज ऑन मनो विशिष्ट आत्मा यू कैन सुपरइम्पोज दी स्वदेह धर्म वंस ओन देह धर्मास और वंस ओन इंद्रिय धर्मास ओनली वेन यू ऑलरेडी हैव एसोसिएशन बाय अध्यास बाय तादात्म्य संबंध विद दी अंतकरण विद दी मन देयरफॉर मनो विशिष्ट आत्मनि मनस हैज ऑलरेडी बिकम अ विशेषण टू मी देन ओनली आई कैन टेक दी शरीर स्थूल देह एज माइन दी इंद्रिया विच आर सटलर बट दे आर नॉट दी अंतकरण आई कैन टेक देम एज माई सेल्फ एंड देयर धर्म आज ऑल्सो सो देहेन्द्रिय धर्मान मनो विशिष्ट आत्मनि अध्यस्यति इति तथा इति वी हैव सीन दैट इन दी मूल कृशत्वादि धर्मवतो देहादेहे आत्मनि तादात्म्येन कल्पितत्वात् तद्धर्मः साक्षात् आत्मनि अध्यस्ता इति मन्तव्यम् ऑल्दो दि कृशत्वादि ऑल्दो दि वेदर आई एम लीन और आई एम स्टाउट वेदर आई एम फेयर और डार्क ऑल दीज आर स्थूल देह धर्मास although they are superimposed on the mano visishta atma still they are superimposed on atma therefore deha dehe krushatvadi dharmavatah deha de that deha which is endowed with leanness stoutness etc those kind of dharmas fairness darkness atmani tadatmena kalpitatva since I say that I am fat I am lean I am fair I am dark therefore तादात्म्य संबंध इज देयर विथ आत्मा देयरफॉर सिंस दे आर इमेजिन इन आत्मा कल्पितत्वा तद्धर्मा साक्षात आत्मनि अध्यस्ता इति मन्तव्यम् ऑल्दो देयर इज अध्यास बाय एसोसिएशन विथ वन अनटू द अदर सो देयर इज अ सीक्वेंशियल क्रमेण अध्यास बट स्टिल ऑल द अध्यास टेक्स प्लेस इन आत्मा बिकॉज व्हेन आई से इवन द पुत्र धर्मास आर टेकन एज माइन आई से आई एम हेल्दी आई डोंट से माई बॉडी इज हेल्दी When my son is healthy, my body is healthy is not a statement. When my son is healthy, I feel healthy, I am healthy. So, Atmani Adhyastha. Although they are superimposed on the Deha, really they are superimposed on Atma. Sequentially they are, Kramena they are superimposed, but still it is unto the Atma. You can see it directly also. Because of the Vyavahara, Ando Aham, Gauro Aham, Sukhi Aham, Aham Pushta, all these are other dharmas. अन्यत्र सुपर इम्पोज अन्यत्र आत्मनि सो साक्षात आत्मनि अध्यस्ता इति मन्तव्यम् यू कैन थिंक ऑफ देम एज डायरेक्टली बीइंग देयर अनटू योर ओन सेल्फ बिकॉज ऑफ अहम प्रयोग देयर विथ तादात्म्य संबंध अज्ञात प्रत्यग्रूपे साक्षिणी मनोधर्माध्यासम आह एंड the final meaning, what is the real, the first adhyasa is what? The ajnata pratyag rupe, the pratyagatma is unknown, adhikarana is unknown. If you know the rajju as rajju, there cannot be sarpadhyasa anymore. Similarly, in atma, if all of these are adhyastha, in the pratyagatma, that pratyagatma cannot be known. Prior it was not known. It can be known only later, whereby adhyasa will go away because of ajnana going away. Karana nashe sati karyasya api nashaha. Ajnata pratyag rupe, that pratyagatma which is unknown, that atma which is the innermost self, in the form of the innermost self, sakshi to everything else. Pratyag rupe sakshini, unto that sakshi, manodharma adhyasam ahadi, antakkarana dharmas are adhyastha, tatha antakkarane iti. Similarly, antakkarana dharmas, that was mentioned earlier in the mula as what? तथा अंतकरण धर्मान काम संकल्प विचिकित्साध्यास सॉरी अध्यवसायादीन. सो तथा अंतकरण धर्म, अंतकरण प्लेज द रोल ऑफ मन बुद्धि अहंकार एंड चित्त. सो अंतकरण धर्म आर व्हाट फाइनली काम संकल्प, दिस इज मनस, व्हेन इट प्लेज द रोल ऑफ मनस, संकल्प विकल्पगात्मक मन vichikitsa, then the inquiry into sankalpa, all the options which are created by the mind, the antakkarana which is playing the role of the mind, that time options are given. Should I do this? Should I do that? Every moment there is an option, this or that, this or that. When do you come to a conclusion? When the antakkarana switches the mode to buddhi, then the buddhi is that antakkarana which is nishchayatmika, nishchayatmika buddhihi. So vichikitsa, inquire into that, and vichikitsa adhyavasaya. Adhyavasaya is culmination into a conclusive decision. This or that? Oh, surely that, not this. So that is the play of the buddhi, which is the same antakkarana. Adhin. So whatever the chitta dharmas are there, ahankara, all of these are superimposed on oneself. एवं अहम प्रत्ययिनम, एवं अहम प्रत्ययिनम अशेष स्वप्रचार साक्षिणी प्रत्यगात्मनि अध्यस्य तंच प्रत्यगात्मानं सर्वसाक्षिणं तद् विपर्येण अंतकरणादिषु अध्यस्यति. सो देयर इज अ रिवर्स अध्यास आल्सो, द वे ऑल ऑफ दीज धर्मास आर सुपर इम्पोज ऑन आत्मा, द आत्म चैतन्य सत्ता आनंद आनंत्यम, ऑल ऑफ दीज आर सुपर इम्पोज ऑन दी युष्मत प्रत्यगोचर इदम दि अहंकारादि, विच विल लुक एट इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट. आई जस्ट फिनिश व्हाट इज इन द व्याख्यान बिफोर वी गो टू द नेक्स्ट सेंटेंस. तथा अंतकरण इति, सो धर्माध्यासम उक्त्वा तद्वदेव धर्मी अध्यासम आह एवमिति. सो धर्माध्यास हैज बीन टॉक्ड अबाउट. Similarly, dharmi adhyasa is also there. So, antakkaranam sakshini abhedena adhyasya taddharman kamadhin adhyasyati te mantavyam. So, having superimposed antakkarana onto the sakshi, then alone the antakkarana dharmas which are like kama ityadi, kama sankalpa, vichikitsa, adhyavasaya, these are superimposed on oneself. So, there is dharmi adhyasa preceding. So, antakkaranam sakshini abhedena adhyasya, abhedena means तादात्म्य संबंधेन, एंड देन तद्धर्म अंतकरण धर्म विच आर दोज काम आदि अध्यस्यति इति मंतव्य. देन स्वप्रचार मीन्स मनोवृत्तयः, दी अंतकरण वृत्ति विच आर गोइंग ऑन. व्हाट इज प्रत्यगात्मनि अंटू वन सेल्फ, सो प्रति द डेफिनेशन इज गिवन, द व्युत्पत्ति इज गिवन, प्रत्यगात्मा द इनर मोस्ट सेल्फ, व्हाट डज इट मीन, प्रति प्रातिलोम्यन प्रति प्रति प्रत्यक प्रत्यय, देर इज प्रति प्लस अंचु धातु, अंचु इज अ गत्यर्थक धातु, अ कॉम्प्लिकेटेड धातु, ऑल द फॉर्म्स आर कॉम्प्लिकेटेड, टू मेनी सूत्रज अप्लाई, टू मेनी चेंजेस टेक प्लेस इन अंचु, इज वन ऑफ द कॉम्प्लिकेटेड धातुस, प्रतिपूर्वक अंचु धातु. सो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ प्रति, व्हाई व्हाई इज प्रति उपसर्ग एडेड टू द धातु. सो प्रति इज इन द सेंस ऑफ प्रातिलोम्येन असत जड़ दुखात्मक अहंकारादि विलक्षणतया सच्चित सुखात्मकत्वेन अंचति प्रकाशते इति प्रत्यक. अंचति गच्छर्थ का धातु व्हाट इज द मीनिंग हियर प्रकाशते अंचति प्रकाशते शाइन्स फोर्थ व्हाट शाइन्स फोर्थ प्रति इट शाइन्स फोर्थ प्रति प्रति मीन्स प्रातिलोम्येन एज बीइंग द इनर मोस्ट असत The Atma appears asat, jada, dukkhatmaka, appears to be not there. Meaning, somebody talks about Atma as per the Shastras, we say not. Such kind of an Atma does not exist. Oh, you are a sentient entity, you know. Oh, but in sleep I don't feel my sentience. I feel that I am unconscious. One has to think that I existed in sleep. So, satta is lost on oneself. Chitta is lost on oneself. So, asat, jada. Oh, you are Ananda Swarupa. What are you talking? I am in so much of pain, so much of dukkha, all sorts of dukkha, and you are saying that, and this is another dukkha, that you say you are Ananda Swarupa, you don't know yourself, so you are also calling me stupid. So further pain by, you know, somebody is saying that, when somebody is already in pain, you know, Swamiji used to joke about, or Acharya used to say, somebody has lost someone close, he is in dukkha, you can't go there and make a statement, Tattvamasi. Additional dukkha. So there is already dukkha by saying that your Ananda Swarupa is not helping. He does not know how. We ourselves are taking so long to get a glimpse into that and going to someone who is in such dukkha and you go and give him Vedanta. Nobody wants such jnana. We don't need such jnana from you. We are suffering. Either you join the party, meaning join the suffering, not a party really. You join the group in and suffer with us, share our dukkha, which will lighten our burden. Don't increase it. You can't go and make such statements, especially in a sabha where there is no Vedanta there at all. So what asat dukkhatmaka, asat jada dukkhatmaka, what is that? Ahankara dharma, ahankaradi dharmas. So pratilomyena, as inner dharmas, they are not inner dharmas at all. They are not inner, they are outer. बट प्रातिलोम्येन असत जड दुखात्मक अहंकारादि विलक्षणतया एंड फर्दर इन ऑपोजिट मैनर ऑल्सो सच्चित सुख आत्मकत्वेन अंचति प्रकाशते इति प्रत्यक बोथ वेज सच्चित सुख दिस आर आत्मधर्मास दे आर सुपर इम्पोज विलक्षणेन अंटू देह विषय सुख इज देयर दिस इज दी भ्रांति Satta is there, all the prapancha exists. What do you say that it is not there in the dream, it is Swapnavat? What nonsense are you talking? I can feel the reality of the world. I desire something, the wealth gives me so much. I desire this wealth, it suits all purposes. Then, opposite also, so much, you know, rozmarna ki zindagi. So you say that, yes, you are earning your livelihood every day in, day out. And how can you say all this is mithya? The hunger is real. I need to feed myself. I need to put food on the table. I need to earn. So struggling. Whereas other, I have lot of money. I want to give it away also. I see suffering. How can you say it is all unreal? How can you say karma yoga is useless? You can't say all that. Are you saying all my karma yoga is useless? I have done so much of dana. Is it useless? It is not useless. You can't say it is all swapnavat. So we find these arguments. Even among learned, even among those who have learned Shastras. Therefore, this is an adhyasa both ways. Chaitanya is felt in the sharira where it doesn't belong. Satta, spurti, ananda is felt all the way. It is not there. And I feel that I am going to die. Whereas I am ananta. Ananta. I am ananta tattva. I feel that I am aging. I am dying. This is all what? I am going to be asat soon. I was not there in sleep. Chaitanya wasn't there. So, asat, jada, ityadi dharmas are superimposed on myself. So, it is an adhyasa both ways. We'll see more in the next part. Yamiha karunikam sharanam gatopyari sahodarapa mahatpadam tamahamashu harim paramashri janaka jankam ananta sukhakrutim umtatsat. Any questions? I'll see you in the next part. Hopefully, we'll complete in a few days. Namaste.
Namaste. Namaste.